For those of you who didn't have a chance to head to Paris for Fashion Week, don't worry, we didn't go either. But we're gonna show you our top five looks that we'd love to see on a red carpet ASAP.
Oh, guys, we have to start with Valentino. I combed through every single show wishing I was there, but let's talk about Valentino. Look at these outfits. I mean, God, so stunning. Okay, I had a really hard time picking just five to talk about. This was a look from Valentino's show. I feel like I could hear this look walk by just looking at a photo of it. I can't even imagine what this looked like walking down the runway. It's so elegant, it's completely beaded. I wanna see so many more details, I wanna see up close, but this headpiece is so beautiful how it frames her face. Obviously, it's super over the top.
Right.
But the gown itself is also so, so exquisite.
I could do the gown for a wedding situation,
yes,
like my own wedding. Maybe not the headband,
Not the headpiece, but it's couture, and couture is that experience where it's it's almost more art than fashion. Derek Blasberg, who is the head of fashion at YouTube, was there in the front row with Gwyneth Paltrow, Mr. Valentino, and Gwyneth was actually brought to tears by the show, and you actually see her turning around and wiping tears from her eyes. It was such an emotional moment. Mr. Valentino has since retired, so now the head designer is Pier Paolo Piccioli, and he came out and he brought every single seamstress.
Too?
And Celine,
casual.
Every single seamstress came out afterwards along with the designer and said hello to Mr. Valentino and was obviously brought to tears by how beautiful the show was.
Oh my gosh, Paris Fashion Week just giving us all of the moments.
The collection was over the top. It really went from bold, bold color blocked looks into these more ornate, beautiful gowns. Take me
I know,
there,
I'm mesmerized. We're sitting here looking at the monitor,
watching
with you, and we're like,
wishing we were there.
Someone else who made my jaw drop. I can't even speak. That's how like she just moves me.
Speechless.
Kaia Gerber, you guys. She is like so young, but so talented, so beautiful.
She's so beautiful on the runway, and I totally understand why every designer wants to put her in the most show-stopping piece. So this was Givenchy. And this feather gown, again, really over the top, but I would just die to see this thing on a red carpet. Anyone, please.
This is a Met Gala look.
Met Gala look. This is a big, big moment gown. You know, the feathers move so beautifully on the runway, and they have such a way of looking dramatic, but also being light and airy at the same time. And just a reminder, Givenchy is Claire Way Keller, who also designed
Meghan Markle's
wedding gown. So this was, I believe, her first Haute Couture collection for Givenchy. All the looks were so beautiful. Again, it was really hard to choose. We're seeing a lot of suiting, obviously a lot of humongous gowns, a lot of beautiful draping, and a ton of feathers. Oh. But if I had to pick one to share with you, it was that feathered look.
What about Dior? When I think of couture,
Dior.
When I think of Paris Fashion Week, I always think of Dior.
Dior is a classic. Dior is a staple. Dior actually showed an entirely black collection with the exception of a few gowns, which is why I chose this one. I love the ombre texture in this gown. It's so classic, so beautiful, so Dior. Dior is known for that silhouette of a pinched in waist and a big full skirt. So of course she's going to show one of those. Let's actually look at this little video clip that Dior posted of Shailene Woodley, who attended the show, talking about what she thought of some of the looks.
There was one dress that came out and it had, I couldn't see it quick enough because she went by so quickly, but you could hear the beads hit the floor. So you could feel the weight of the dress, although it looked so dainty.
I totally agree with her. I can't imagine seeing those dresses move and getting to hear them. And
well, you said when we were talking about Valentino,
like
you're like, I feel like I could hear this dress coming from the runway.
So magical.
Fashion.
Super jealous. I wish I could be there. Okay, moving on to the place I wish I could be, the Chanel show. So Chanel, obviously known for showing in a beautiful, fantastical location, helmed by Karl Lagerfeld, who recently passed. This is one of the first couture shows without him. And the location was still very beautiful. It was a library. And all the looks were very polished, very traditional Chanel, lots of suiting.
Yeah,
I chose this beautiful off-the-shoulder dress as my pick because I could see a really young star wearing this.
Like, 100%.
Like a Millie Bobby Brown or somebody. Mm-hmm. Because I love the short hemline. It's so elegant.
Right.
But so
the
polished.
One shoulder, love it.
Yeah.
Still a little pop of sexiness.
Right,
here,
and a little
skin showing. Yes,
so chic. I mean, it's Chanel. Of course, it's chic. Last but not least, a designer we don't talk about a lot, Schiaparelli. And the new designer at the helm of this collection is very young, 33 years old. First collection for Schiaparelli. And this was the finale dress. I absolutely had to show you guys this dress because it is a work of art. Lady Gaga, I'm speaking to you.
Mm-hmm.
Wear this, I don't care where you're going. You need to wear this
you
dress.
You mean you're not going to wear this to work tomorrow?
Tomorrow, just going to show up at my Haute Couture.
Casual day at the office. I mean, well, speaking of, the whole consensus that I have of these looks from Paris Fashion Week is there's really only one thing, is we need to take ET Style Feed on the road to Paris for the next Fashion Week and give you the show from Petty. Sorry,
that would
I'm really
be ideal.
Excited about it.